Today we're talking about the federal budget, a sentence almost guaranteed to get everyone to change the channel. I bet a few of you might be thinking, gee, I wish I could go back to that ad. Maybe I should check out how to make my own website on WordPress. But I promise, this is going to be an interesting episode. You see, there are people out there who watch the federal budget for fun, and you thought bird watching was boring. And we recently realized something. Soon the military might not be our government's biggest expense, which is quite the achievement considering this country spends so much money on the military, I can only assume our next stealth bomber is fueled with $20 bills. So what is the expense that's replacing military spending? Well, it turns out we funded our public education and schools so well that, I'm just kidding, it's government debt. Specifically, interest payments on government debt, which is the number one thing a government could spend money on that people of all parties could come together and say, yeah, that benefits nobody. Don't worry, Congress has vowed to make sure this won't happen by increasing the military budget by an additional $61 billion. Unfortunately, I couldn't really find any mainstream punditry covering this because, well, Trump's penis isn't going to describe itself.
My hands, if they're small, something else must be small. I guarantee you there's no problem. I guarantee.
Okay, never mind. So what's up with this debt interest rate issue? Well, it's no secret that the US has a lot of debt. In fact, that was something we actually talked about before the 2016 election. But the problem here is that, as anyone with a credit card or student loan will tell you, with debt comes interest payments. According to the Congressional Budget Office, last year we paid $263 billion in interest. And before we go to the elephant in the room that predicts that by 2028 that number could go up to $915 billion a year, let's put our current 2018 interest payments into perspective. Our 2019 budget shows us paying $363 billion on interest, or 8.2% of our entire national budget. And good news everyone, that's more than the government is spending on food and agriculture, unemployment and labor, energy and the environment, international affairs, transportation, science, health, housing and community, and education combined. And I could throw in another $42 billion on top of that and still be under these interest payments. So now that I have your attention, what are we even talking about? I mean, what is the national debt? It's not like Trump gets Xi on the phone and asks if China can write us a personal check to fund our missile program.
In 2 weeks, we get the 10-year and the 30-year reopening auctions, and those will be, I think, very telling, because will there be demand for this much longer, much more interest rate risk product than we've seen this week?
Oh God, we're talking about bonds? The only thing that can make stocks look interesting by comparison. When a country needs money, their treasury goes to the open market and auctions bonds to the highest bidder. And it turns out that the American bond market isn't just funded by grandparents who have absolutely no idea what gifts to get kids these days. In fact, the country that America owes the most money to isn't actually China, but America. So Americans, you think you can cut this country a little slack? Come on, let it slide for a few months, you know it's good for it. Well, you can't do that because of two words, open market. If we offer reduced rates to certain people, well, then they'll sell off our bonds and buy something else. Which leads to conversations like,
you try to buy debt back at a discount, interest rates are going to go up.
No, you can buy debt back and
pay for it.
You buy debt back and you take advantage of certain things. You can, as an example, there are people, large holders, you know China right now has $1.8 trillion of our debt? Okay, 1.8, and they're cheating us. And they're friends of mine.
They're not going to sell to you at a discount.
Okay, no, you never know. You never know. All of a sudden they have to sell at a discount. You don't know that.
Oh, I know. Because instead of selling debt to America, they could again sell their debt to literally anybody else for full price. It would be like me expecting someone to give me a dollar for 70 cents. Because, hey, I don't know. You don't know. Maybe they'll do it. There was one important piece of that interview that gets ignored though, because mentioning interest rates is a surefire way to guarantee people will immediately stop listening.
You try to buy debt back at a discount, interest rates are going to go up.
Okay, that might sound boring, but bear with me because this is where things start to get potentially really expensive. because gradually rising interest rates would have made borrowing more expensive even without additional debt. Although additional debt we are accruing with tax cuts and massive spending increases. But I want to circle back to these interest rates for a second, because this is something that nobody, including me, normally talks about, despite the fact that when viewers fall asleep, they watch ads all the way through. These are important in the context of debt, because these are the interest rates at which the US can borrow money. So when they go up, any future money we borrow gets more expensive. That's why it's bad to hear things like,
welcome back. Interest rates have been rising. The 10-year Treasury yield striking a multi-year high this past week, hitting 3.1% at the high for the first time since July of 2011. Should investors fear bonds just because yields are rising?
All right, what is happening there, though? Well, basically, the government is constantly borrowing money with IOUs at fixed rates. And because you can sell those IOUs to other people, we can figure out a price, which gives us an idea what demand is. If the price on IOUs is up, then clearly somebody wants it, so the government can sell its next round of debt at a lower rate. But if the price of IOUs is down, well then that next round is gonna have to be more expensive to get someone to buy. I mean, during World War II, we didn't make those buy war bonds posters because we thought they'd look cool on hipsters' walls in 60 years, or because we wanted the American public to make sound investments in long-term financial securities. No, we wanted to keep the price of money cheap. Now, before some viewers start hyperventilating into a paper bag because, oh no, the US is borrowing at a 3% interest rate right now. In the scope of the last 20 years, this is still a pretty decent rate, but it does seem to be trending in the wrong direction. Alright, so we have interest rates rising slightly and debt rising somewhat faster than slightly. This might sound like it's a terrible time to have a smile this wide, but you're either forgetting something or leaving me an all caps message in the comments section right now. In which case, sorry, but you might have to hit backspace a few times, because
moments ago, the numbers for America's economic growth, or GDP, were just released, and I am thrilled to announce that in the second quarter of this year, the United States economy grew at the amazing rate of 4.1%.
Oh yeah, after reading all this bleak economic news, I sometimes forget how great the economy is right now. 4% is really good, and while there are plenty of reasons to be worried, well, because that's what economists do, debt repayment isn't one of them. This is why debt is generally presented as a debt to GDP ratio. Think about it this way. Would you rather have no debt and no income, or $10 in debt while earning $100 a month? You can't really talk about debt without talking about income as well. That said, the government calling GDP income would be like an Amazon warehouse worker taking personal pride in Jeff Bezos getting a pay raise. An increase in the GDP only matters to the government insofar as they can tax it. According to Forbes, the federal government collects tax revenue equal to about 20% of GDP. Alright, so what does that mean? Well, and this is approximating, GDP would need to increase by $750 billion, five times the foregone tax revenue, to replace the revenue reduction from tax cuts. The current US GDP is $18 trillion, so $750 billion is a little over 4% of GDP. Now you might be jumping for joy saying, Stephen, we did it, because again.
And the government released its gross domestic product report for the second quarter this morning. It showed the US economy grew 4.1% from April through June.
And if you attribute literally all of the growth to tax cuts, then we did do it. Problem is, we were rooting for breaking even on tax cuts when we're in a lot of debt and increasing our spending. The answer is, we can either grow faster than Trump's ego, without needing to pay off new tax cuts or spending increases, which is the answer our president would prefer, or we increase taxes while slowing or even slightly reversing growth in order to start making revenue. If we maintain the status quo though, here are a few graphs from the Congressional Budget Office. Debt interest payments will become the largest percentage of the budget by 2023, taking 13% of the funds by 2028. You've already seen this one, but interest rates will be at almost $1 trillion a year by 2028, And that's just the interest on debt. And lastly, debt as a share of GDP will rise pretty steadily. Now this is just the Congressional Budget Office predictions, and if Congress knew the future, well, they might have an approval rating high enough to make me not feel the need to hug Paul Ryan every time I see it on the news. Hey buddy, it gets better. If even half of that prediction is true though, we've got some changes that we need to make. Anyways, until next time, thank you and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan comedy news, remember to subscribe by clicking this floating logo to the right of my head. Or do it the old-fashioned way by clicking the subscribe button below. Remember to click that bell so that freedom will continue to ring. And give me a thumbs up. But lastly, as always, thank you for watching.